What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today's actually a pretty exciting day. I think we're going to be bringing home a new car. So, I'm sitting in our 2014 Chevy Equinox right now. Actually, I think one of the very first videos I ever posted on this channel was me sitting in this car going through this car wash. The video was absolutely terrible. You can go back and watch it. I'm pretty sure it's still live. I think it was episode 1 or 2. But it's kind of ironic. We've come full circle. Going through the car wash, getting it washed one last time before we trade it in. This is actually my wife's car. This was her first car that she ever bought brand new. We were married at the time, but for whatever reason, it was her car. It was her daily driver for quite a while, and then I took it over when I sold my Chevy Cruze. And I've been driving it for a little over a year now. Put 84,000 miles on it, and we've had absolutely zero issues with it. I love this car. But it's time to get something a little bit different. So, a little sad, but exciting things to come.
Avery's first time in a car dealership. Probably won't be her last, obviously.
Avery, what do you think? Yeah. You're already stealing Mama's money, huh?
Don't flash my ID at people. She's learned at a young age that the wallet's important.
Yep.
I think it could just be because of the llamas. So we'll see if she's figured out the money part. Okay.
What do you think about getting rid of your car?
It's really kind of sucks in a lot of ways, because it's like, as a car, it had great performance. It's really quick, very responsive, and it's red. It's a beautiful red. So it's the best car ever. On an emotional level, I mean, that was the first car I've ever bought. And it was new. It had like 200 miles on it. Basically, I got my job and I had a 50-mile round trip commute. And my hand-me-down Nissan Pathfinder was, man, it got over 100,000 miles, like, I think a year before I started my job. So we were like, okay, now that I have a career, I should probably get a new car. And so that was my first car. And it was great. We took it to California a lot. We took it to day trips to Sedona. We took it to a lot of places. It got around in the state. We didn't do too long of trips or anything. And then on top of it, like, that was the first car that we brought her home in. So, like, that's a pretty big deal.
Where are you going? There's a mask, yeah. Bring it to Mama.
Come here. So I'm gonna miss it, but I know there's always part of the game is, you know, you gotta, you know, get a different car every once in a while. But this is definitely interesting because it's, as I said, it's the car we brought her home in, and I love it. It's a great color. I'm just gonna be so sad. We're gonna be the most boring colors. We went from having a blue car, red SUV, white sports car, all Chevys to, well, you'll see.
Hi. Hi. You funny.
Hi.
Hey, gentle. Dada, you see the car?
Hi.
Gentle, kiddo.
I know you're excited for the new car. Well, it's not really a car, but
new vehicle. All right, guys, back home. We've got the new vehicle. You ready to see it? Let's go ahead and take a look.
That's right, it is a 2018 Chevy Colorado ZR2. Some of you guys were pretty keen and already guessed it. I've had my eye on one of these trucks for quite a while, and this one just happened to come up, and it was really weird. Me and my wife were just discussing over the past weekend what kind of our future plans were, and then the whole purchase thing happened pretty fast, and this one was available here locally, and we picked it up at a pretty good price. Here's a look at the interior. Pretty standard Colorado, except you got the ZR2 nameplate on the sill here. You got ZR2 on the headrest. That's pretty cool. Already got Avery's car seat in the back. So let's go ahead and hop in here. It still smells new. The car has about 17,000 miles on it. 17882. So yeah, I couldn't be happier. It was a pretty good purchase, I think. I'm gonna have a lot of fun with it. I'm not gonna go over it in detail because, like I said, I'm gonna do a full comprehensive review here shortly. So mine does have the 308 horsepower direct injection dual overhead cam V6. I didn't really want the diesel. A lot of people, for whatever reason, like the baby Duramax. Honestly, it doesn't have enough power for me. It's pretty slow. This gets up and goes pretty good. And I'm not really going to be towing anything, so I don't really need the torque. But, I mean, look at it. It looks brand new. Everything is so clean on this truck. Now, the truck is awesome as is, but there are a few things that I want to change right off the bat. For example, the original owner put these Chevrolet Heritage badges on the truck. I'm not really a fan of that, so I'm gonna put some black bow ties on it. You know, the standard Chevy bow tie. For the front, I actually have, it's actually a GM accessory badge. It's an illuminated Chevy black bow tie for the front. So I'm gonna do a video on that coming up here shortly. I'm also going to debadge the truck, get rid of the Colorado on the side, get rid of the badges on the tailgate, leaving the bow tie on the back, obviously, but getting rid of the Colorado and this stupid dealer plate thing they put on there. I hate it when dealers do that. So it also came with this hard tonneau cover. This is a $1,400 add through GM accessories. I'm not really a fan of it. I don't know, there's just something about trucks. I like the open bed look better. It is a cool feature, but I think I'm gonna be taking it off, probably selling it. If anybody in the Phoenix area here locally has a Colorado and wants to buy this off of me, I'll sell it to you for, let's say, $800. That's a pretty substantial discount. I mean, the thing is practically new. I mean, the truck only has 17,000 miles on it, and it has two sets of keys. It is lockable here.
All right, guys, that's going to be pretty much it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Many more adventures to come with the truck. Still, the Corvette's not going anywhere, so a lot more content to come with this thing too. So if you enjoyed it, please smash that like button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.